exponential and logarithmic functions. So how do we apply exponential and logarithmic functions? So for exponential functions, they say exponent is a term used in mathematics to indicate the number of times that a quantity is to be multiplied by itself. So anytime you see that the number of times that the quantity can be multiplied by itself, then we are looking at this. We are looking at what we are talking about the exponent. So an exponent will be written as a small number or letter at the upper right of the base. Now let's look at the definition. So then the exponential function of f with a base a is f of x is equal to a raised to the power x, where a in this function should be greater than 0 and not equal to 1. When a is equal to 1, then the function does not fall within the domain of the f of r. So you see that the range must fall between 0 and infinity. Or about 0, but if itself is not in the same range of A, then we have what we call logarithmic functions. So the logarithmic functions in the previous section, we observed that the exponential function are 1 on 1, and it implies that an inverse function under this composition. So you see that for the first function, we have f of x is equal to a raised to the power x for a greater than 0 and not a equals to 1. So if you have 1 here, then you have 1 raised to the power x. So we write g of x is equal to the log of a into x. That is to say, y is equal to what? Y is equal to log of a. If I only use a raised to the power y is equal to x, if not, it will not be correct. So the domain of the log of a must be between 0 to infinity. And the range must also lie between a negative infinity and a positive infinity. So one way to think about logarithms is to just know that the number of log of a and x must answer the equation of to one power of 1 raised a to base x. So if we raise a to a certain power here, we have x. If we raise a to 1, if we raise x to a to 0, we have 1 and not x. So we cannot, decide to see whether the power, answers that equation. Unless the power raised to a must lead us to the answer x. So these are just how to calculate growth rates. So there's a table. Yeah, this table. You see the table is represented by countries with high income, countries with low income, countries with population of low income countries, and then you have the growth rates that have been calculated. So the growth rate, the average growth rate of per capita of various nations here is between 1990 to 1999 is presented here. So Nigeria should fall here, middle income country, and there is a middle income country or a low income. Sometimes they say they are low, sometimes they say they are low income, depending on the growth rate of the country. So there's something we want to say. So the country with the highest growth rate of income per capita during this period, 1990 to 1999, is China, with an average growth rate of 9.6%. This is what we have in this graph to represent. That's China. So South America minus 0.2, Latin America 1.67. Then this question 6.1%. So why the disparities in growth rates are striking? It is not immediately obvious what the implications are for future levels of income per capita. So to address this question, we begin by determining the general relationship between growth rates of the variable in that country at this level, these different moments in time. So probably when you look at the moments in time that runs within a country, you can define what the goals will be. So thank you, I think that's the end of our class. I hope you understand what all these are, and then more materials are on the site, on the website, so you can download and have more understanding of this. Thank you, and goodbye.